What's your approach? The approach gotta be more gorilla on it.
Well, stop all that goddamn noise. We're trying to do something in here, pal.
The flow is just let it come, you know? It just flows. I see it and then I talk about it, you know, and I repeat it. You know, I have bullet points. I don't have a set. I say I'm going to start here and go here. I go there, I come back. Whatever way it takes me, you know. I just ride the talent. I think comedy is very important. I think we're the third pulpit, if you say. You have, of course, your preachers, then we have black radio, you have your journalists in it. But comedians, herself, back in the days with Richard Pryor and the rest of it, social issues should be talked about. I just think it can be funny and it also can be truthful. And that's just where I'm at. I have always been that one. I was the one that came up and said, how did OJ kill two people with one knife? What was the other one doing when you were stabbing the first one? Though that's funny, but realistic. How do you kill two people with one knife? And, you know, and that's just always been. I always look for that kind of hook in a joke.
Yes, we can change the world.
Change the world, they
said. It's historic. I mean, if you ask my mother and father, they never thought it would happen in their lifetime. I never thought it would happen in my lifetime. And, you know, though I am a Republican, because, you know, I don't think $250,000 is a lot of money for you to say you're going to be raising taxes on. It's a lot of his policies I don't agree with. But for me as a black man, I think, it's very important that we show that that ceiling can be broke. So, you know, in the barbershop, you can tell that brother who said here, man, I will work for, you know, FedEx, but the white man holding me back. Now, if a black man can become president, they mean Barack Hussein Obama. You can't tell me these white men are keeping you from getting a job at FedEx.
You know these colored folks and Negroes hate to see one of their own succeeding. America surprised us and let a black man guide us.
Old God, territorial, new God, new territory. I think, you know, it's self-explanatory, you know, and our present, if you was to put our civil rights leaders for all the great things they done for them, we still have the same problems, our schools, our health care, crime in our community, you know what I mean? We don't own anything. I tell people a lot of times that integration was a bad business move. All it did was make us give up all our business and integrate into the majority, and now we're nothing but consumers. Though everybody said, you know, you wanted to sit at the dining room table and enjoy the same as our, you know, Caucasian friends. But nobody said, hey, man, if we're going to sit down here and eat this pie, you at least need to buy this sugar from us, or we're not going to buy your pie. Hell was sitting, when we were segregated, we owned things. We had our own clubs on. We came up with rap, and we don't even own it. We're just consumers. So that's only my beef with the past. And right now with Obama, it's just it's more global. When I was growing up, I just thought it was black and white people. I didn't know about the Chinese, the Koreans, Right now, as a black man, you have to compete against all. Somebody from India is going to take your job. You know what I mean?
They say we NIGGER, we are much more, but still we choose to ignore the obvious. We are the slave and the master. What you looking for? You the question and the answer.
Psychologically, I can't understand as a race that allow any word to even come to even a discussion that it could even define who we are as a race, that we even having this dialogue. I think it's always been a part of a psycho, I mean, in our psyche, that they have anything about over us. And I'm talking about the people that be. Me and my friend was riding today, and we went by and saw, you know, Cracker Barrel. It's a restaurant, makes million, and I could never have Nickel Barrel, ever. You understand? They'll be sitting around here protesting and everything. Now, Cracker is a racial slur. They have Cracker Barrel, but you see it doesn't offend them. Because, you understand, it's opinionated. It's all about perspective. Now, if you perceive yourself as that, and you care what this person think of you, then you're damaged. As black people, now one thing I admired the most we had when we was segregated and everything that we had one belief that we didn't care about nothing else but one person's opinion, and that's God's. Somehow when we integrated, and somehow when we got into main of our social leaders and so forth, we lost that. And that morality deficiency right at this particular point is all the way down to our kids, that now they actually have shows on TV called The First 48 Hours where they show our kids killing each other and put it on primetime TV and broadcast it all around the world. That's what I'm upset with. To the point that we'll see right now that they are throwing our kids in jail, showing how they kill each other, neighbors against neighbors. Catch you in 48 hours because you shot your neighbor down the street, put it on TV and send you away and give you life. And you worried about the word nigga? We have a problem with our own, and can't nobody fix that but our own. So I don't care what you call it, it's what you answer to and what you believe. That's just how I feel. When I hear black people say that, and it's younger brothers that call themselves being rebellious, you protect your corner but not your country. If you don't have a country, you don't have a corner. You represent your neighborhood but not your country. I look at my country the same way I used to look at my apartment. I love my apartment, I just hate my landlord. You understand? So in other words, I love the country, I just hated the people who ran it. You can't hold the country accountable for the people who run it. It's the greatest country in the world. It speaks for itself. There's no other country in the world, and I have traveled to give you this opportunity. And you're a free man. If you don't like it, leave it. You either can make it better or you complain about it. About being in the military, it's the best thing that ever happened for me because I got to see other different races, and we had to coexist with a common goal that we had a job to do. And then I found out there's no difference. We had more in common than we had difference. And that's why I love the military. Meeting Eddie Murphy was pivotal. Meeting Howard Stern was pivotal. It's endless. L.A. Reid, just the people I was able to meet, you know, the access to people that I look up to. And they're familiar with my work. It's still a journey. So, you know, being in my first major film, and I'm part of the junket, you would say, and being a part of that, major accomplishment. So those are the things that I'm most proud of. Upcoming projects. I'm in the Long Shots, the movie with Ice Cube, Kiki Palmer. We're doing an animated show with Kanye West called Alligator Boots. That's going to be on Comedy Central. Coming up with an hour comedy special. Check your local listings for whichever station we're going to do distribution with that on. And just touring, man. Just coming up with the stuff, being a better father, you know, and doing some more movies. That's really in the next. I see my career is just continuing to be a better actor and honing that craft. It's, you know, I've been through some personal things in my life, you know, with my situation, and comedy hadn't been funny. But unfortunately, like a lot of people, I had to go to work. It's hard to be funny when shit ain't funny. You know what I mean? But it's now I'm back to be funny. Things are cool. I'm at a better part for myself creatively, and I'm just ready to compete with it. And whatever project comes, who knows? You know what I mean? It's such a subjective game here that you don't know what it is. You know, opportunity with preparation, we'll see. With the great Lord, you know, it's endless.
Your approach gotta be more gorilla on it.